This last year has left us all grieving in some way or another.
Whether it was not doing what you normally did as part of your routine, or, you know, many people didn't see their families for a whole year, and all kinds of things in between.
And Jason B. Rosenthal isn't a stranger to grief. He turned into one of the most well-known widowers when millions of people read an article written by his wife.
10 days before my wife died of ovarian cancer, she wrote and had published a modern love column in the New York Times, and that column was called "You May Want to Marry My Husband."
That essay pushed Jason and his grief into the spotlight, leading to a career in writing and speaking about loss and happiness in a way that people often don't.
I never anticipated that this would happen to me in my life, but, you know, in a way, I think that Amy did.
Although there's no cure-all for the stress and sadness we're going through, there are ways that can help you cope.
You know, we celebrate our births, and we should, of course, right? But pretty much the only thing that's certain after that is that at one point we will die, and it is not a secret.
So that's why Jason says we should talk about it.
Talk about these heavy topics now when you're younger and you're healthier, because it would be a real shame to go through that process with so many open questions, you know, especially for the person that's left.
We tend to think of death as such a taboo topic, but by being open about it, we can better prepare ourselves emotionally. But when that time ultimately comes, don't forget to look out for you.
Grief has no timetable, but it's also different for everyone. And so take the time that you need to really work into some of that.
And don't feel like you have to do it all alone. Lean on others for support.
Eventually, you're going to figure out something that I figured out, which is that I'm here and I'm left.
You're looking at the next blank page of your life story, and it's up to you what you write.
Someone come up to me pretty early on and say, "Jason, I know this part is really tough, but I promise you, at some point you will begin to find some joy."
So take time and find the light.
We do hold on to grief indefinitely, especially if we love so much, but you take baby steps.
Ultimately, you will find something to make you smile a little bit, even if it's just listening to a song or seeing a sunset.
And then you sort of step back into that anxiety and fear and all of those things of grief. And then, you know, take a few steps forward and find that joy again, dancing at a concert or laughing with your friends or whatever it is.
Little by little, you'll learn how to live with your loss.
Eventually, that joy and that light will emerge, but we have to find it.
Healing from grief is at the top of the list.